Gastrointestinal tract, it starts from oral cavity. That is the first part of the gastrointestinal tract. And it ends at the anal canal, which is the last part of gastrointestinal tract. The oral cavity, which you are seeing here, yes, this is oral cavity. It opens posteriorly into the muscular tube, which is the second part of the gastrointestinal tract called as pharynx. Pharynx is divided into three parts. First part of the pharynx is nasopharynx, second part is oropharynx, and laryngopharynx is the third part. Nasopharynx is the part of the pharynx which is present behind the nasal cavity. Oropharynx is the part which is present behind the oral cavity. And laryngopharynx is called as laryngopharynx because it is present behind the larynx. Now this laryngopharynx, which you can see here, that this is the blue portion, is laryngopharynx. So this blue portion, which is laryngopharynx, it continues inferiorly with the trachea, which is the windpipe, which you have done in your respiratory module. Whereas the same laryngopharynx, it also continues inferiorly with the esophagus, that is the third part of gastrointestinal tract. In this module of GIT, we will start the gastrointestinal tract, or we will teach you the anatomy for gastrointestinal tract from esophagus, and we continue down till the rectum. Oral cavity and pharynx we will do in other modules, like in head and neck. Esophagus is a muscular tubular structure about 10 inches or 25 centimeter in length. It continues above with the laryngeal part or the laryngopharynx opposite to the C6th or 6th cervical vertebra. It inferiorly extends down, pierces the diaphragm at esophageal opening, which is present at the level of T10, and continues with the cardiac end of the stomach at the level of T11 or 11th thoracic vertebra. It means that it pierces the diaphragm at T10 and it joins the stomach at the level of T11. Now you can see here, this diagram is actually showing the course of the esophagus. This is esophagus. This blue color structure is trachea, and behind the trachea lies the esophagus. It runs inferiorly. It pierces the diaphragm at its esophageal opening, which is present at the level of T10, and it joins the cardiac end or the upper end of the stomach at the level of T11. This esophageal opening is present in the right crust of diaphragm. Now the course of esophagus. Esophagus, it starts its course in the neck. In the neck, in front of the vertebral column, it runs down. Laterally, it is related to the lobes of thyroid gland. And anteriorly, it is in contact with the trachea and recurrent laryngeal nerves. Then it enters the thorax by passing the superior thorax aperture and passes through the superior and posterior mediastinum. You know that what is mediastinum? Mediastinum is basically the central area or the center portion which is present between the two pleural cavities, or you can say that it is a central part which is present between the two lungs. At the level of the sternal angle, which is basically the manubrio sternal joint level, the aortic arch pushes the esophagus over to the midline. Now esophagus enters the abdomen, and from here the course of abdominal part of the esophagus starts. It enters the abdomen by passing through esophageal hiatus at the level of T10 and joins the cardiac orifice of the stomach. It is accompanied by two vagi, branches of left gastric vessels and lymphatic vessels. Two vagi means two vagus nerves, which are basically parasympathetic nerves, and they are cranial nerves, right vagus and left vagus. These two vagi nerves, they basically provide the parasympathetic supply to the whole gastrointestinal tract. The length of the abdominal portion of the esophagus is about 0.5 inches or 1.25 centimeters long. You can see here, this is esophageal hiatus, which is present in the right crust of the diaphragm, and this small portion, only about 0.5 inches long, is the abdominal portion of the esophagus. Now, the arterial supply of esophagus. Upper third of esophagus is supplied by inferior thyroid artery. Middle third of the esophagus is supplied by esophageal branches from descending thoracic aorta, whereas lower one third it arises from the esophageal branches of left gastric artery. It means that arterial supply of upper one third, middle one third and lower one third of the esophagus varies.